17-year-old Emily Muteti is steadily climbing the ladder towards greatness. She is already a multiple national record holder. We caught up with her in Mombasa as usual, training hard, a routine that she has perfected. Training is twice a day, the first session from 6 a.m. to 7:15 a.m., then the second session from 5:30 p.m. after school to 7 p.m. All this under the watchful eye of a coach and her mother, Emma Muteti, who does not compromise when it comes to both education and training for competition. Her mother is the one who introduced her to competitive swimming after watching her take to swimming effortlessly.
I used to swim only in school before, so then it was just a matter of swimming for fun. So then she's like, you should try swimming, something just to keep you there.
Emma Muteti is the supervisor of everything. Through the mad traffic in Mombasa, she manages to get her to her training sessions together with her brother. She will then stay through the session and take her back home to prepare for school as she goes to work. As a junior swimmer, most of the competitions have been age group meets across Africa, with South Africa and Zambia the most common destinations. Emily vividly remembers when she started out on the international competitions.
So my first one outside the country was in 2011. That was in South Africa. It was tough though. It was competitive. Good meeting other swimmers.
Mombasa is the hub for many swimmers due to the number of swimming clubs and schools that participate in the competitions. Being a star in her age group, Emily is quite famous in Mombasa, but her shyness does not allow her room to bask in the fame.
I actually hide it to myself. I just hold it in me, though I try to be nice, always smiling, so I think that would cover up for my shyness.
2014 was meant to be her year to announce her arrival on the international arena of major competitions. She qualified for the Commonwealth Games and even stepped up her training for the same. But a week to her departure for the Games, disaster struck.
Actually, I had been training for the competition months before. We were doing hard sets with my coach. So then it reached a point that I just felt I couldn't go anymore. Actually, I was now feeling that I was getting weak and weak and weak. So then I was just told that I had to get steroids and all that so that it pushes me back up.
The disappointment did not put her down. It rather became a motivation to work even harder to achieve her goals. In a family of five children, only her and one of her brothers are swimmers. They are a tag team, training together, studying together, and doing gym sessions together. They are basically each other's pillar as they focus on the goals ahead. The rest of the family act as the support cast, especially her grandparents in England, who provide the material support they require for training and competition. Away from home and the pool, Emily is a student at Wima Academy, a school that encourages students to achieve their goals without supervision. We spent a day in school and the results were there to see. All the students have their work set for the day and work on their own, the teachers acting as supervisors rather than tutors. School starts at 8 a.m. and ends at 3:30 p.m., giving Emily and her brother enough time to prepare for the evening training sessions. The two are part of the school swimming team that has won many trophies over the years. As we turn to 2016, Emily has set her sights on reclaiming a ticket to a major championship. The target set seems huge and demanding, but she's determined to achieve it.
A tourist Olympics, because that's like the final goal I'd want to be, and maybe like make the finals, being the top over there. That's my goal I'd want to be.
The season starts early, and so does the hunt for Emily Muteti. For Citizen TV, I'm Mike Okinyi.